You know, I always try to put that narrative of me trying to get my name out for myself. But just coming in and trying to get better, you know, Rob has told me that there's a great development system here. So I just want to come in and get my work in and get better every day. But I never really had a thought of, you know, me going to play with my dad, but that's always, you know, there to, you know, take part of. But that wasn't a main focus of mine today.
Hey guys, over here, Jovan Buha with The Athletic. One question for each of you. Just entering the league as rookies, what area of your game are you looking to work on most coming in this summer?
For me, probably just creating my own shot. You know, I feel like I know how to play the game already and play the right way, but just being more aggressive on the offense end and creating my shot because I know that's what I can do. Just being more aggressive.
I'd say the same thing. Just go in, be aggressive, be ready to make some shots, and then just show my all-around game is one thing. Just show all around and be a complete player.
Kobe Bryce, Southern California News Group. Got one for both you guys. Bronny first, kind of going off of what you just said. Because of the time you had to take off at USC, do you feel like there were parts of your game you weren't able to showcase as much because of that? And do you feel like, you know, once you're able to, I guess, get back on the court more consistently through summer league, you can, I guess, reestablish the offense rhythm you may not have had at USC?
Yeah, for sure. The time that I had off, I feel like I could have been perfecting my game more. Yeah, I just feel like I've been given the opportunity to, you know, showcase what I can really do because I wasn't given that much of an opportunity at SC. So, you know, I'm excited for what is to come.
And for you, Dalton, you kind of mentioned this, I think, in New York. You studied JJ while in college. Rob, you've mentioned that JJ was drawing up plays for Dalton right after you guys drafted him. Is there an added excitement or element of excitement just knowing that, you know, you'll be able to pick the brain of one of the, you know, best shooters that league has seen?
Yeah, for sure. Me and Coach Barnes, we watched a lot of JJ Redick and how he comes off screens, gets openings, creating space even before he runs off the screen. So I'm excited just to learn from him and see how he sees the game.
Bill Plaschke, Los Angeles Times. This is for Bronny. How much more pressure is on you playing on a team with your father, and how are you going to handle that pressure?
For sure, the amplified amount of pressure. I've already seen it, stuff media and stuff in the internet and stuff talking about I might not deserve an opportunity, but you know, I've been dealing with stuff like this for my whole life. So it's nothing different, but it's more amplified for sure. But I can get through it.
Hi, JJ. Mark Medina. Good to see you again. I understand this part might be fluid, but at least initially, what do you envision what that player development program will look like specifically for Dalton and Bronny?
Yeah, I think just in general, the player development program we're trying to build is holistic. I think oftentimes when people talk about player development, they talk about ball handling and shooting and passing, and certainly the mechanics of playing basketball are an important part of player development. But it's also tactical. It's about reads. It's about incorporating film, incorporating analytics. You know, we will hopefully in the next few days or a couple weeks hire a director of player development program that sees my vision. It's nutrition. It's how you take care of your body, your work in the weight room. There's also, I think, a big part of player development, and it's for someone who has lived in this league a long time, a big part of this is the mental development and all the ups and downs that come. I had a chance to spend a few minutes with Dalton this morning, and one of the things we talked about is just being open-minded, having an openness, and just letting go of outcomes. And the thing that excites me about both these guys is that their basic basketball is as workers, and that's a great starting point if you want to develop into a great NBA player. I'm not sure what's going on with my mic.
This is for Bronny, Darren Haynes, KCAL. You talked about writing your own story, and I heard your father, LeBron, talk about that as well. And we see him back here almost allowing you to have your own moment to write your own story. How would you describe your story right now?
to be honest, just living it, just living by the days, trying not to, you know, care about whatever other people think about me, because there's a lot of people that, you know, have something to say. But yeah, I'm just taking it by the day and staying sane while doing it.
Over here, Michael with NBCLA. For Dalton, and then one for Bronny quickly. For Dalton, as JJ said, they didn't think you'd be there at 17. A lot of people had you going top 10. Is that going to allow you to play with a chip on your shoulder? Have you already remembered the teams and the players that got drafted ahead of you? And for Bronny, now that you do know you're going to be teammates with your dad, how does your experience growing up, pickup games, you know, all the videos we see you guys playing in the driveway, help you as you guys learn to play together?
I would say, of course, I know all the players and teams, but I'm just excited to be here in the right place, and I'm excited just to get to work here and go out and compete.
Yeah, for me, just building that foundation of playing the right way. Like I said, just being that guy to be coachable and you know, play my role and, you know, keep working while I'm doing it.
Bronny, David Pingelor, KTLA. Being around, obviously, the NBA and your dad, is the process going to be easier for you to get started, knowing what to expect and what you grew up around?
I had my own basketball stuff going on, so I wasn't really, you know, in my dad's pocket all day, you know, following him around the Lakers facility. But, yeah, I've had some stories, but there's not. I don't know what, you know, exactly is to come.
So I have a question for each of you, and then one for JJ. The numbers. Got to ask you, Dalton. You wore number 3 all the way down from high school, all the way down. Now you got the nickname Connect 4. Did you come up with that name? And then also, got to ask you, Bronny, number 9 when with the Lakers. Everyone thinks of Nick the Quick, Nick Van Axel, but with you, it was a Juice WRLD situation with you. You have 9 on the side of your ear, too, as well. Talk about that impact. And then, JJ, for you, when you see their shooting ability, Bron and Austin Reeves and AD, like, running high splits, how do you see them fitting in situations like high splits and pin downs, too, as well?
I knew eventually, like, I probably would have to run into number 4, but 3's been my number my whole life, and then, yeah, 3, AD got it, so why not do Connect 4, why not?
Juice has just been a big part of, you know, me keeping calm in some situations that I've been through. So, yeah, just paying homage to him, especially because he passed, you know, as a really important thing for me.
We're back. I think you have to surround your best players with shooting in today's NBA. Spacing is at a premium. And as a coach, you know, there's a lot of plays that you don't have control of. It's over half the offensive possessions, right, are coming off a make or a miss. So it's important that you also have players that have a good feel for the game and can read and react. You know, we want to implement more structure, and with structure, you certainly need a high basketball IQ. But at times when there isn't structure and you don't have control, you also just have to have a feel for the game, and both these guys can shoot it, and they have good feel.